That's right. But for everybody.
Oop. Her everybody. Table. Her table. That's all.
I'll take care of it when it comes up. You'll hear it. Well, I wouldn't leave. I'd hear it when it comes up.
Good evening. I'd like to call the Columbia County Commissioner Board to order today on this February the 5th, 6 p.m. We have all commissioners here, and I'm going to ask Commissioner Allen to open us with the invocation.
You would all please bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father and Creator, we come before you this evening, humble in your sight, asking that you be with us as we go about the people's business. Please guide us with your wisdom and allow that all that we do will be true and just in your sight. Thank you for the many blessings that you give all of us who reside here in this wonderful community. Thank you for people that serve us, the people that are on our staff, the first responders, those that give of themselves, the benefit of those that live in our community. We thank you for all of these many blessings, and we ask that you look over those people as we go forward throughout these days. Amen.
Please stand for the pledge.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, republic, nation, God,
again, we have a full quorum. Commissioners, you have the minutes from the previous meeting of January 15th. Book, if they meet with your approval, I'll accept a motion to do so.
So move.
Second.
All in favor signify by raising your right hand. All opposed, like sign. Carries. Got the agenda. Let's see. I think we have a couple of people that want to speak.
We do, Mr. Chairman, and also have a request from the applicant of item I-1B-1, the appeal of the occupational tax denial. The applicant is here and has requested that we table that until the next meeting. Obviously, you
okay.
Take that up at that time.
Well, I just want to welcome everybody to this commission meeting and thankful that everybody came here, and then just want to say that if you want to watch these proceedings, they are recorded. I'm not sure why you would want to do it, but they'll be on the website in a couple of days, I guess. Is that right, Mr. Patrice? And at any rate, we have that available for you. To the special recognitions, first I just want to say I thought I saw some Boy Scouts walk in. These two groups, can we the Scouts stand up and tell us their name and what troop they're in, what school they go to? Welcome. Welcome. Glad you Scouts were able to come tonight. I hope you learned something and pay attention. You probably will. So, at any rate, again, on special recognitions, also the first for me, but one of our counterparts from Richmond County is here, Commissioner John Clark from the, it's the 10th, is there a 7th or 10th? And so, welcome. Glad to have you. Again, special recognitions, I know that Commissioner Merlier has a presentation that she's going to give, so I'll ask her to step down front and do so.
Tonight I'd like to recognize our Employee of the Month. If Hope Marshall from Engineering Services will please join me up here. Steve Exley, Steve Castle, anybody else? Come up here with us, Matt Schlachter. You've worked with her as well. I have heard so many wonderful things about Hope. Let me tell you a little bit about her. She grew up in Columbia County, and she was hired to assist the road construction department back in 2002, and they only had 4 employees back then, and now you have 13 employees. Has really grown a lot. In fact, she's lived through a lot of things, including the expansion of Washington Road, and we survived that, and she's still here to tell the story. She currently serves as co-director of Region 2 Georgia Utility Coordinating Council. That's a lot. That's a mouthful. And she's past chair of the Local Utility Coordinating Chapter. She serves on the county's United Way Campaign Fundraising Committee and leads the Engineering Services Department's Adopt a Family for Christmas fundraiser. So she does more than just come to work and go home. She really cares about the community. And in her spare time, she is an active member of Trinity Baptist Church and enjoys spending time with her family, her husband Jason, and her children Jake and Bella. So congratulations. Let me hand this off, and I think y'all have some nice things to say about her as well.
I just do want to take a moment to tell the commission and everybody what a special employee that they have in Hope Marshall. She was here before I started in 2010, and I just remember Matt said, you're in good hands, and so thank you, Matt. Been great. Our department does a lot of different things in the county. We work with a lot of different departments. Our main function is project delivery, which is working consultants and taking a project all the way through construction. That's a lot of work. That's a lot of information that gets exchanged and constantly changing information. And she's the best thing about Hope is she's an excellent communicator, and that's very valuable. Highly organized, and she's very steady. I mean, I don't really think she's had a bad day. At least you hide them very well. We all have bad days. But she gets so steady every day. You just know that she's going to produce and she's going to be there for you. So on behalf of our department, thank you.
Had a few bad days. Unfortunately, you were the reason. Pardon me. No, now, Hope has a tough job. I mean, on the scale of weirdos, engineers rank just below IT people. And so, and so to have to deal with a whole office of them, like I can't see how she does it. They hand something to me and try to get an attention for me to get enough concentration or Steve enough concentration to sign something. She does it. She's persistent. She'll camp outside the doorway and wait. You got a minute? You got a minute? And then she'll have the notebook she wasn't ready to sign telling you everything about it. But I'm not sure any projects would get done or delayed if it wasn't for her. Hope's a great. We've been very blessed with our administrative staff between she and Renee. They pretty much rank me. I follow whatever they say, and if A and Hope don't say it's okay, it's probably not. Thank you for all you do.
I really don't work with a bunch of. I do tell my guys, though, that I am. I'm blessed, and I do work with a bunch of good folks. All for making my job.
Congratulations. $100 for Employee of the Month? Is that
yep.
it?
That's right.
Taxes withheld.
And a day off or something?
Day off. Oh. Stay away from those Ohio State weirdos.
Sorry, I missed. I'm still new at this. I missed part
and
of it.
Do we still do the umbrellas?
Employee of the Year.
We do.
Oh, okay.
Easy.
That's
now.
For the year.
It'd be Employee of the Year to get an umbrella.
Thank you. Back to our agenda. I know there have been a couple of folks who asked to speak tonight. Anybody who wants to speak, just have to take one of the forms, fill it out, and give it to Ms. Crawley up here. There's an Asa DeBuck filed in advance to speak. Or not. Please state your name and address for the record.
Asa DeBuck, 101 Misty Woods Drive, Grovetown, Georgia. We have a piece of property that we purchased back in 2002. Upon purchase of it, they water facility there had been recently drainage issues solved. So initially they were going to build a big berm on our property, take down our front fence and build a berm to redirect the water. But as they looked at that, would actually redirect the water closer to the house, cause more problems than it fixed. At that time, a few years later, our sewer system failed due to the significant water drainage coming from the facility, so we had to have that moved. And they had re-looked at it, and I'd asked them if maybe if they, because really there's a sort of what could be a little bit of stream, but it's not very deep, so the water spreads out across the property. If they could deepen it so the water would move faster through the property instead of saturating in, they stated they couldn't do that. At this point, a few years later, once they had expanded the new facility, the heavy rainstorms got so significant it brought water and it flooded our dining room area. And I had to rip up all the flooring and get that replaced. And so I tried to mitigate with French drains as much as possible on that. And I finally got the storm and drain people to look at there, and they verified that the water was from the facility. And not only that, that the tank had a significant leak, that leak water saturating my property as well. And so it's been almost 17 years now, and the problem hasn't been resolved. And I've recently have a job change. Property, unless this water issue solved. Old Columbia County has bought in the line to the right and left of us directly because they want to expand the water facility. I would like either to get the water redirected so it's no longer going across our property, or if they need to buy the property, just buy it the fair market value. As long as they could get it fixed by this summer so I could get the house up for market, that would be. But without that, I'm in a bad place. Thanks for
any questions or comments.
Forgive my asking, sir. Is this your first approach to the county for your problem?
Yeah, directly. I've gone through storm. I've called different offices. The water facility is aware of it and brought this up. They just stated that to tell the people who are buying the property that they fix it. I've been saying that for a second. Can't really, in good faith, say, hey, this is be resolved. I've had to pull up most of the flooring and the floor, we've had to seal the foundation, put in French drains. I've done a lot to try to mitigate this, but there's still moisture, mold issues and stuff, and I have to get that water load property. I added some pictures, proposal that they can shows. I drew in where it shows how the water's flowing across. If that is helpful, and then they, with the new facility, there's a new drainage system. Probably just cut across a culvert pipe. Redirect that water. Their pipe that they have that is supposed to be the storm drainage, the water doesn't even go to. Higher than everything else, so it runs across and goes across our property. I do have some videos that we could do, or any person can just go there during a rainstorm.
Scott, where would you suggest we take this?
Well, I was just going to ask if you've, can you let us know who you've spoken to? Do you have the names of the people that you've spoken to?
Yeah, I can get that. I don't offhand know those names.
Probably the best thing to do, Mr. Chairman, is to have, this is the first I've heard of this. So since we coordinate with all departments and ultimately I oversee those departments, that you would give me all of the information you have to my office, and then we can take a look at it from there and see and communicate back with you. And then if you're not happy with the outcome of that, then of course you can bring it back to the board.
Super. Thank you very much. Somebody else, Mr. Rick Berry. Again, please state your name and address for the record.
Chairman, I'm Rick Berry, 57 Longleaf Road, Trenton, South Carolina. Import tonight. Friend here, Zach.
Good afternoon, Zach.
Last time I was here, it was at the invitation of Mr. Allen, and it was Chairman Cross's birthday, and I wasn't here to complain then, and I'm not now. I'm actually here to report on 2 years of Kiwanis Club activities, and thanks to the community for the support we've had. We're in the process of adding new members. We've got two key clubs, Lakeside and Greenbrier. We've got a third one forming at Evans High School. Key folks helped us to get the club off the ground. Robert Kelly, David Deakle, Daniel Burroughs, August Murdoch, many others, and of course, Dr. Caraway, Penny Jackson. We've been active with the Chamber and Workforce and Education Committee. particularly the Students in Business Project and a number of others. Camp Sweet Life is our partnership signature activity. It's being held out far away, but it's moving soon, hopefully, to the new facility the Y has locally. We raised $14,000 to help support that in a partnership with the Georgia Children's Hospital. I want to introduce the next club president, Zach Tefteller. He grew up in these parts. He's active in the community here and in Augusta. As we said then, and it still is, this is not your father's Kiwanis Club, and we're looking forward to some additional support from the community. Any questions?
Questions? Congratulations, Zach.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
You. Appreciate you coming.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we go down to the consent agenda. Everything on this agenda has already been through committee and received the necessary votes to be placed on this agenda, so we will accept approval all with one vote. So, motion to approve. Then.
Moved.
Second.
All in favor signify by raising your right hand. Carries. On to new business in the debate. Commissioner Galeas.
Resolution 1905. Community Emergency Services. Resolution 1905, amending the fee schedule for the Evans Town Center Park and Columbia County Amphitheater and amending the event contract. First reading. I make a motion to approve the first reading of Resolution 1905, amending the fee schedules for the Evanstown Center Park and Columbia County Amphitheater and to amend the event contract.
Second.
This is to bring fees in line with actually seen from folks we've done business with. The first reading, so there'll be a second reading. Or you have two more weeks to work through this to make sure that you're all in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Carries. Next point, and Mr. Johnson, you said that the person wanted to table this appeal of the occupational tax denial.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, the applicant is here, but he requested that he be able to table this until the next commission meeting. He has some additional information that he wants to provide and hasn't been able to do that yet. But that's certainly it's on the agenda. You can, anybody wants to entertain that motion, or you can move forward with it.
Chairman Lear, you on your committee? Generally, we'll give folks the opportunity to do that if they so choose.
Make a motion to table.
I make a motion. I make a motion to table later date.
Can we designate? We need to table to a designated date, so it can be the next commission meeting next or any meeting that
commission
you decide.
Commission meeting. I make a motion that we table this until the next commission meeting 2 weeks from tonight.
That's sufficient for the applicant.
Just come up, if you don't mind, come up to the front so everybody can hear you. State your name and address for the record, please, sir.
That's for about 35 years. Happy to be there first and get out of your way.
Yeah, well, I generally will work with folks.
Whichever way.
But for the next, but the next meeting's okay with you.
Sure.
The next meeting, next commission meeting, okay. There's a motion.
I second that motion then.
Any other discussion for tabling this? Till next meeting?
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your right hand.
Aye. But,
oh, well, now you have a third.
Thank you.
All opposed? Motion carries 5-0. Next, Member Lear.
Got a lot on the list today, if you'll be patient with us. I make a motion to approve the rezoning request for tax map 079095C and 078A220 from C2P1 to S1. for a proposed self-storage facility subject to the conditions enumerated in the January 17th, 2019 Planning Commission report.
Second.
Well, the chair will second the motion and hear the debate. Johnson, can you tell us a little bit about this?
I'm going to defer to Mr. Slocker on this.
This is a request to self-storage to be somewhat climate controlled, some not climate controlled. Off Columbia Road, it does meet our growth management plan. Any other questions you have?
Debate? Questions?
Can you kind of just go into the topography over there, Mr. Faulkner? And
yeah, so if you look at the site, if you start on the upper side here, lower side, it's got some pretty good fall across the site, I believe, off memory, 12, 15 feet. Brandon, you might know. And if you start in the back corner back here and come to this corner, it's a little over 20, 25 feet foot, I believe, fall. Have you had your civil engineer look at it yet of how he's going to step that down? You got a good plan of how it's going to work?
Can you state your name and address for the record, please?
Good evening. Brandon Grable, 3603 Burning Tree Court, Martinez, 30907. I don't know exactly. So this entire property is falling drastically. The way our site plan is set up, this entire parcel here is about an acre and a half. We're really just using that for stormwater purposes. So we're leaving all of this area here as natural buffer. We've met with the neighborhood. In fact, we met with their HOA at their last board meeting, and their HOA president spoke in favor for us at the Planning Commission. So the neighborhood on board with what we're doing. And Ms. Richardson, I think you were asking about the privacy or the buffer area, but all of this is natural buffer. And again, this has fallen probably 20 something odd feet going towards the neighborhood entrance back here. We've got a 60-foot buffer on the back here. We've spoken with Regions Bank. They're on board with what we're doing, and we're actually got the elevation drawing of this wall here. So this is a view of the side elevation. We've broken it up with the masonry water table and then batten board shutter look, just to kind of break up that wall going along the border of the Regions Bank property.
So is everything going to be inside, or is there going to be some outside?
Yeah, so the goal here, if we can go back to the original site plan. So this is the outside wall. Everything faces in, okay? So all of your doors will be internal, and really, other than a gate here, everything faces internal to the site.
Any other questions?
Is anyone here from the neighborhood has any comments?
Evidently not.
I think there was some opposition, the first Planning Commission, and then y'all tabled, I think, and obviously y'all got together with the neighborhood after that and ironed out any.
Yeah, the reason we tabled is, one, we were revising our site plan, and then the Planning Commission wanted to know a little bit more about the materials we plan to use, as well as the neighborhood, and so we met with the neighborhood. In fact, everyone that was here at the first Planning Commission, I wrote down their name and number and had them attend HOA meeting.
Comments? Motion on the floor. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. All opposed?
I make a motion to deny the request for tax map 077003B. A major S1 plan revision to revise building setbacks, buffers, and landscaping, building size, and site design, subject to the conditions enumerated in the January 17th Planning Commission report.
Second.
Any discussion or debate? Questions? Matt, can you please give us a quick 30 second?
Yes, sir. This is a request to change the buffer requirement to allow construction of a stormwater pond in that bottom left corner. To do that pond there would pick up some water leaving the Wifesaver pond. This pond will be designed to take the Wifesaver water as well as construction water, and it will require a change in the buffers setbacks to build it. We'll have about an 8-foot wall to hold that pond in. We'll also require some fencing to build the pond from the neighbors. It is behind a residential lot.
Where is the current water runoff for the Wifesaver right now?
That one is somewhere down in this corner.
There you go.
Nope.
Go back. This is the Wifesaver lot here, that corner there.
Right in the center where one of those buildings is. Where it
Their plan is to catch all that water and put it into their pond.
Right.
Questions?
So Wifesaver is then going to effectively going to share retention?
No, sir. Wifesaver still have their own retention. It's just when that water leaves their pond, this pond will then collect it. So it actually go through two ponds.
What happens to this water if they don't get their retention?
They'll have to design around it. There's some erosion. They state some erosion issues. They'll have to design around it. The pond will go where they originally planned for just collecting just their water, and they'll have to allow this water to bypass their site.
And the buffers, and what size is the buffer going to be then?
It would meet the conditions that were required in the original zoning. 40-foot buffer.
We heard the name from neighbors in back at all?
Other questions?
I just want to comment. I think it's in the best interest of the neighborhood behind it that we keep that larger buffer that went with the original proposal.
A motion on the floor to deny zoning change. All in favor of denying the change, raise your right hand. Carries. Back to you, Ms.
I make a motion to approve the request for a conditional use for a tattoo shop for tax map 0623085.
Second.
A newly constructed building here. It does have C2 zoning. This put a tattoo parlor there. It will require conditional zoning, so it does meet with our management plan. Staff did recommend approval.
Any debate? Questions? In favor of the approval, signify by raising your right hand. All opposed?
I make a motion to approve the rezoning request for tax map 078D050 from C2 to C3 with a conditional use for an automobile storage lot, subject to the conditions enumerated in the January 17th, 2019 Planning Commission report.
We have a second. Any discussion? Locker?
So this is an existing here was going back in 77 by the county. Our use tables have changed, so this non-conforming use that was in place will allow them to maintain their use while their lease with Camperland runs. I believe they have 2 more years on that lease. A 3-year limit on this condition of zoning, as well as the next item you'll take up, which is that 3-year time limit applies to that as well.
Question on any other discussion? Floor, all in favor, by raising your right hand. Like sign, motion carries.
This motion is in relation to the previous motion. I make a motion to approve the request for the property owner of tax map 078D050 for a variance to section 9098 to reduce setbacks for the existing buildings and 90139 buffers to reduce required screening in accordance with the conditions enumerated in the January 17th, 2019 Planning Commission report.
Second.
Any discussion or questions? Already been addressed. Everybody in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Opposed, like sign. Carries.
I make a motion to approve resolution 1904. Is this mine? Did I go too far?
You're good.
It's still mine. I make a motion to approve resolution 1904 adopting a moratorium on the rezoning of property to the planned residential, planned unit, or S1 districts for the purpose of constructing or locating homes smaller than 1,000 square feet and the issuance of new business licenses involving the sale or display of recreational vehicles, manufactured buildings, or mobile homes.
Second.
Walker.
Yes, sir. We've had some inquiries into small homes, tiny homes. Currently, our code allows small homes, I believe, 100 square feet. However, the issue we have with tiny homes is they're not built on site. We don't have the ability to inspect, make sure they meet our code. This moratorium allows staff time to work with figuring out if we're going to use independent certification. They can watch these homes being built at a factory that we will accept, come in. The business license part is to prevent somebody from coming in and open a business to sell these tiny homes. Then you can't sell them because we don't allow them to be put in place. So allow us time to work out all those details. We'll bring those back to you very soon for your input and your vote.
My understanding is just to slow this process down until we understand it and have a code in place to deal with it. And this was for 6 months, is that not correct? Discussion?
Matt, does this involve RA residential land? This pod?
Dealing with the houses that been affected. They're on a trailer, right?
Some of them are on trailers. Are built, you know, if they're built in place, they meet code. It's just when they're built in a factory outside of the county that we don't get to watch, they bring them in and want to hook up permanent power. Well, we have our building official doesn't have the confidence to approve a power connection to something he didn't know how it was built. That's the details we got to work out.
Yeah, it's good to get ahead of it.
Does it expire in 6 months, or is it 6 months or until we come back with a...
I believe it's written as 6 months. Or if you had it earlier.
Could be sooner or later.
No. But it doesn't go past six. It stops at six.
We think we can have everything before. We try not to extend these moratoriums just forever. We try to put a reasonable period of time on it so... Staff will act, and we'll get something to you before it expires.
Any more discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. All opposed, like sign. Motion carries.
One more in this section. I make a motion to authorize the chairman to sign a letter of commitment for matching funds in the amount of $100,000 for the Central Martinez Access Management Study.
I'll second.
This is a MPO project. We have funds available through the Metropolitan Planning Organization, $400,000. We have to do a match. This is a study to look at access management in Martinez, as it states, but it does require a 20% match from the county. If we do get $100,000, this money will come out of T-SPLOST, the discretionary money.
This is a way to turn our $100,000 into $500,000.
Like that, man.
My understanding from conversation with Castle earlier that hopefully that we get this back. It's not a study that we're going to, it'll go on a shelf and just be tabled away, but that identify some real needs there and those are, is that correct, Mr. Casper?
That is correct.
Yeah. You went to Ohio State, get a little grace. Motion on the table, all in favor signify by raising your right hand. Like sign. The Public Works, Commissioner Richardson.
Make a motion to approve $296,493 to purchase water administration generator BRW Construction Group, LLC. 57037.25.015.54.
There a second?
Second.
Discussion? All in favor signify by raising your right hand. All opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Any legal matters?
No legal matters tonight.
Request for review by committee. I don't even remember that one. Public comments? None. We have executive session. Issues, you have three items. What's your pleasure?
I'd like to not go into executive session and just take care of business in public.
A great idea.
I'll read my motions.
Please.
I make a motion to approve $54,300 to Mason McMurtry Properties, LLC, Parcel 1, $54,000 to Surfside Property, LLC, Parcel 13, $16,000 to Bertha Freeman, Parcel 33, $8,745 to William C. Stone and Rebecca B. Stone, Parcel 34, $29,669 to Gospel Water Branch Community Development, Inc., Parcel 43, $80,000 to Richard Makerson, Jr., Parcel 78, and $107,000 to Sonia Sharma as trustee of the Sonia Sharma Gifting Trust, dated December 10th, 2012, Parcel 114, to obtain right-of-way and or easements for the State Route 28 Furies Ferry Road Widening Project.
Second.
Thank you. I'm getting nervous.
Crackers. All in favor signify by raising your right hand. All opposed, like sign. Matt, how many more pieces?
144.
Okay. All right, this one is for Lewiston Road. I make a motion to approve $110,000 to Jam Ministries, Inc., Parcel 37, $61,409 to Edward Eugene Hare, Parcel 52, $115,000 to CVS 75947 Georgia LLC, Parcel 58, $7,000 to Miriam Lodora Rupert, Parcel 82, and $17,000 to John A. Weeks and Linda L. Weeks, Parcel 93, to obtain right-of-way and or easements for the Lewiston Road Widening Project.
Second.
Thank you.
All in favor signify by raising your right hand. All opposed, like sign. Last one.
One more. I make a motion to approve $58,199.90 to Doris and Anthony Garnett, Parcel 37, for relocation replacement housing in relation to the Furies Ferry Road Widening Project.
A second, sir.
I'm going to explain that one.
Required is cost to relocate those folks from buying that home. It's a DOT process we have to go through.
So they're moving.
All in favor signify by raising your right hand. Opposed, like sign. Motion carries.
143.
All right. There's nothing else on the agenda, so any other motions need to be made?
I move to adjourn, sir.
Second.
Signify by raising your right hand. You're closed. 37 minutes.
A bit longer.
30 minutes is a good time.